Let's say that K in this case is equal to two confirmations. In other words, Rusty will assume that the transaction is finalized after two confirmations. I published my transaction to Rusty and it has been included within the block. One confirmation, two confirmations. Rusty notices the two confirmations and feels confident about the transaction's finality. He now sends me the iPhone so as to not keep me waiting. But that was exactly what I was expecting. This whole time, I was mining on a private chain, which I did not reveal to the rest of the network. This chain contains a transaction from the same UTXO to a different address, which I also control. This transaction from me to myself is to make sure that the transaction from me to Rusty is forever invalid and can never be republished. This is because once the network accepts a transaction from me to myself, the corresponding UTXO is used up. And since both this transaction as well as the transaction from me to Rusty spend from the same UTXO, this then invalidates the transaction from me to Rusty. So when I broadcast my chain, the rest of the network accepts my chain over the previous chain because it's longer. Because of this, the entire network of blocks containing the transaction from me to Rusty and onward is invalidated. The rest of the network will continue mining on my chain, meaning that I will have received Rusty's iPhone while still keeping my own money. Hooray! I've successfully double spent. However, notice that my double spending of Rusty rely on my ability to produce a longer chain than the rest of the honest network. You might be wondering, what is the probability of me being able to produce a chain longer than the rest of the network? Well, we'll see right away how that's possible.